Hi everybody, this is Noelle from Petitti's and we are doing a Shasta Daisy spotlight. They are looking gorgeous in the month of June and they're really such a happy flower. It makes everybody happy and smile. So what you need to know about Shasta Daisies. First of all, they love full sun conditions. So that's that 6 or more hours of direct sunlight on their faces and foliage. They love that. Southern, Western, Eastern exposure, fantastic, as long as it's 6 or more hours. Soil. The thing that they do like about soil is that well-drained soil, we constantly talk about that. Northeast Ohio, we're just blessed with a lot of clay for the most part. And so we wanna make sure that we're adding organic matter to our soil in order to help increase drainage, okay? So again, use your compost, your sweet peats, your planting mixes. When you're planting, incorporate that in with your existing soil. It really, really helps the drainage. And here's the little caveat here, well-drained yet moist. Shasta daisies use a lot of water. So initial planting, like Taylor was saying, when you initially plant them, they really do need quite a bit of water and they'll absorb a lot of water. So irrigation needs to be regular. It's usually that 1 inch of water, 1 time per week, very slowly and deep watering. That's always gonna be the best for them in the morning, okay? So keep that in mind. Feeding. Typically it is like most perennials, it's twice a year, okay? Once in the spring, once in midsummer. And we usually start the spring feeding with plant tone and iron tone, that combination. In midsummer, if you wanna feed them plant tone and iron tone again, that's fine. Or Angelo often recommends Osmocote for that midsummer feeding because it really gives them a shot in the arm, if you will, and it gets them to fill out and become more floriferous again. So that's really, really good. Deadheading. You know Shasta daisies, big flower. They definitely like to be cut. The more you cut, the more that they produce, more buds. It used to be the old-fashioned varieties were less vigorous. They didn't repeat bloom as often. Now, most of these varieties that are available now, the breeding has become wonderful as far as repeat blooming, vigor, and just being very prolific bloomers. But of course, again, with a big flower, when they do start to die back, you definitely want to remove them, keep this plant as clean as possible, and then go ahead and they'll fill out again. So typically with deadheading, you pick the size of the stem. You want a short stem for cutting or you want a long stem for cutting. Either or, it's fine. And if you want to, what you can do, and I saw one on this one, is there's a side shoot here. So many times they'll have a side branch or a side node. You can go ahead and cut the flower stem down to that side node, or you can go even deeper down the stem. So we'll show you that. With all of these daisies, they again grow so prolifically. And if you've grown them before, you know that they really do need regular division, typically every 2 to 3 years, okay? So don't be surprised that your daisy patch gets really big in 3 years in the garden. Go back in there and go ahead and divide typically in the spring. You can do divisions in early fall, but we typically like to get all of that, all of the old stems out of the way. You just have the base of the plant that is just filling out in spring. And that's when you can go in with a sharp shovel or trowel and really dig out a clump and go ahead and move them or pot them up and give them away. They're a great plant to share with neighbors and friends and family. Other than that, uses. They are a fantastic pollinator plant, especially for the butterflies and the bees. Again, a shallow daisy type flower where they can land and perch and go ahead and just, you know, feed on the nectar and the pollen that's right in the center of the daisy is always going to be excellent for your pollinators, okay? So they really, any color of Shasta daisy, it's really up to you, but they'll always be a great pollinator plant. They're also a really good deer resistant plant too. Has a lot to do with how they can be a little bit smelly, so they do have an aroma, but also the thicker the foliage, the fuzzier the foliage, the better. So with these guys, they do have really good resistant traits as far as deer resistance. in the border. There are all different sizes. So Taylor's gonna work on a chart for you so you can see which ones are the shorties for the front border, which ones are medium height for middle border, and which ones are taller for back border. And that's always great to know, especially if you like that different height level in the garden. And other than that, there are so many different varieties. So we're gonna go through here. This is a bigger test than the coral bells, folks, because coral bells are all different colors, but these are hard to identify. So hopefully I can figure this out. So I'm gonna start out with one of my favorites. This is called Freak. And Freak is actually sort of a split petal type Shasta Daisy. Really, really thin petals towards the center of the eye, and then thicker petals on the outside. There's about three or four tiers of petals here on this plant. This is one of the shorter varieties. Kid you not, in the pot, it's probably about 6 to 8 inches tall. And in the garden, it's the same way. So very, very compact. So Freak is a real neat one. Again, profuse bloomer, no problem. If you're looking for yellows, I love this one. It's called Goldfinch. It is a beautiful kind of creamy yellow Shasta. So if you're looking for that color, it's fantastic. Very, very strong, sturdy stems on this plant. Again, excellent for cutting, but all of them are. I missed Banana Cream. So Banana Cream is gonna be a PW variety here. A little bit shorter stems, but a very, very soft yellow as well. So that's a good one too. In the back, this is Snow Lady. Snow Lady has a little bit of a smaller flower, if you will. It's only about 2 inches in diameter, but again, very profuse, very clean, usually a single petal, raise around the center eye there. This tall one in the back is called Whoops-a-Daisy, and Whoops-a-Daisy is known for just being very, very profuse. The flowers are around the 3-inch mark wide, so they're very large, flat. Again, about 1 to 2 tiers of white petals here on this plant, okay? As I'm moving closer, and I'm gonna pick up Brightside just to kind of show you, when they're growing in pots, they tend to stretch a little bit, so they look a little bit taller in the garden center than they actually are in the landscape. But Brightside has very leathery foliage. Again, single tier of petals, so like your classic daisy there. Paladin, check this one out. The tiers on this plant, there's probably 1, 2, 3, 4 tiers of petals on this flower. Again, it's a really big flower, about 3 inches wide. Absolutely gorgeous. And then I like this one too. This is Real Glory, and we've shown this before. Kind of starts out with a very, very light creamy yellow color, but the center stays creamy yellow and the petals start to fade into like a cream to white color. So very showy eye on this one. Pretty tiers, about 3 tiers of petals. And then Real Dream is going to be sort of a yellow counterpart to that. And the petals curl a little bit on that one. So Real Glory and Real Dream are pretty new varieties out there, but really showy flowers there. Okay, Taylor, I think I've hit most of them. Do you think? She's shaking her head. Yes. So you'll get to see all the different, sizes and heights. We'll show you that. Make sure you plant them in full sun. Make sure you do divide them about every 2 to 3 years, because again, they are very aggressive growers and they're great to have around for cut flowers and of course the pollinators too. Enjoy.